Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
So we are reading from Chaitanya Charitamrita Adilila 17th chapter verse number 20. Tabe shuklam bare ra kaila tandula bhakshana Hare Nama Shlokera Kaila Artha Vivarana
Hare Nama Shlokera Kaila Artha Vivarana
Tabe Shuklam Barera Kaila Tandula Bhakshana
Hare
Nama Shlokera Kaila Artha Vivarana
Hare Nama Shlokera Kaila Artha
Vivarana
Matajis. Tabe thereafter Shuklambarera of Shuklambar Brahmachari Kaila did Tandula, raw rice, Bhakshana, eating, Hare Nama Shlokera, of the verse celebrated as such. Kaila did, Artha, of the meaning, Vivarana, explanation, translation purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. After this incident, the Lord ate raw rice given by Shuklambar Brahmachari and explained very elaborately the import of the Hare Nama Shloka mentioned in the Briha Naradiya Puran. Purport. Shuklambar Brahmachari resided in Navadvip on the bank of the Ganges. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing in ecstasy, he approached the Lord with a begging bag containing rice. The Lord was so pleased with his devotee that he immediately snatched the bag and began to eat the raw rice. No one forbade him. Thus he finished the entire supply of rice. We'll read one or two more verses. If you have on your mobile, you can proceed. Hare Nama, Hare Nama.
Hare Nama,
Hare
Nama.
Hare Nama,
Hare
Kalo nasti eva, nasti eva. Nasti eva, nasti eva. Nasti eva, you can read translation. Kali Kale Nama Rupe Krishna Avatara Nama Hai Te Hai Sarva Jagata Nistara. Yes, Ashok Garbhu.
In this age of Kali, the holy name of the Lord, the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, is the incarnation of Lord Krishna. Simply by chanting the holy name, one associates with the Lord directly. Anyone who does this is certainly delivered.
Dadya lagi hare ra nama ukti tina bara Jada loka bujaite puna eva kara Murli Prabhu. Magyantimirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yutaha Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsta Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitam Shya Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Vyayvacha Patitanam Pavani Vyo Vaishnave Vyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabho Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Krishna. So we are continuing the discussions on the chanting of the holy name, its importance and its practice. So today we have chosen this particular section where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving instructions in the house of Shuklambar Brahmachari. So this particular section is very deep and very instructive. We have been hearing about the importance of the holy name. But in this section, we will see Lord Chaitanya is instructing of how exactly, what is the consciousness and the mood in which we should chant the holy name. So it begins with today's verse where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is in Navadvip and he is performing his pastimes. And here he is accepting the rice of Shuklambar Brahmachari. Shuklambar Brahmachari was a very simple brahmachari staying in Navadvip. And he had simply a simple bag around his shoulders and he was carrying some rice. And this rice is not like very special rice, basmati rice, but this is some broken pieces of rice which people give to beggars. Generally, we do not give to beggars something very valuable. What is discarded, what is of not much material value, is given to the beggars. So here, Shuklambar Brahmachari is having some broken pieces of rice and is wandering around from home to home in Navadvip. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Supreme Lord, is running after him. And he is snatching the rice from the bag of Shuklamba Brahmachari. So this is because Shuklamba Brahmachari possesses pure devotion to the Lord. The Lord is Bhavagrahi. He accepts things which are offered in love and devotion. Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam Yame Bhakti. It's all right, Prabhuji. Hari Bol Prabhu. Please attend. Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam Yame Bhaktiya Prayachati Tadaham Bhaktim Paritam Ashnami Prayatatmana. If one offers with love and devotion a leaf, a flower, some water, I will accept. Shuklamba Brahmachari is not even offering to the Lord, but the Lord is going on his own and snatching from him because he had got pure bhakti. If somebody is offering many, many delicious items to Krishna, but if he does not possess bhakti, then Krishna will not accept. We see in the Mahabharata that Duryodhana wanted to offer Krishna so many items. When Krishna came to try for a reconciliation, Shanti Duta tried to be a messenger of the Pandavas. But because Duryodhana does not have bhakti, so Krishna rejected his offerings. And instead, he chose to go and accept the offerings of Vidura. Vidura is a very simple person, born in a Shudra family. He is not a millionaire, he is not the king. But he has got devotion. So Krishna is so pleased, and Vidura's wife is so much in ecstasy that Krishna is going to accept the offering, that she is just peeling the bananas, and in ecstasy she is throwing the bananas and feeding the peels. Patram Pushpam Phalam Chilkam. Even if it is simple, Krishna is accepting. We find in the Gajendra story, Gajendra is in great distress, being attacked by the crocodile, and he is offering Krishna a flower, and Krishna is accepting the flower. In the Ramayana, we find the story of Shabari. Shabari is offering some fruits, and she is so much in ecstasy, she is tasting the fruits, and those fruits which are good, she is offering to Lord Ram. Those which are not good, she is throwing them away. Because we cannot imitate that. We are not on the Raganuga level. But the essential point is bhakti. Similarly, in our chanting also, every mantra should be mixed with bhakti. Just like if you cook gulab jamuns. You know how we cook gulab jamuns? Anybody knows how to cook gulab jamuns? Gauri Prabhu, you know? How to cook or how to eat? What do you know? Both. How many know how to eat? Almost majority. How many know how to cook? You know? Okay, next time we have program in Murari Prabhu's home, we will have gulab jamuns. You know, Ravitri Prabhu, how they cook? What is the process? After frying the balls, then it immerses in the sugar juice. And I just happened to go to one home 2 hours before the program, because my train was coming out that time. So I could observe one day the cooking. Generally I come just right at time of prasad. But one day I saw how it is being cooked, and they put the balls in the juice for a long time. What happens if you just put it and take it out? Most of our time our chanting is like that. We are just Hare Krishna, we are just touching. Today I am speaking not about you, about myself, because I am very time conscious. And I am trying to change to become Krishna conscious. Of course we have to be time conscious also, because time is also Krishna. But you are directly conscious that every ball of gulab jamun has to be immersed in the juice in such a way that the juice enters into every pore, you know, like andandasta paramand, like everywhere. So when you taste it, it's just like so happy. Just like by hearing, you are feeling happy. So how much you'll feel happy if you taste it. So when we are chanting, This juice is that concentration, that attention we have in chanting. We have to make a conscious effort. It doesn't just happen automatically. It's just, if you just say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, and do not make an attempt to concentrate, then naturally the mind will wander. You have to make a conscious effort, and it becomes easier with prayers, with offering some prayers before beginning or while chanting. You know, for some simple prayers at the feet of Sri Nam Prabhu. Like Prabhupada recommends, Swayam Prakash Prabhu, those books are not here today, the chanting books. Prabhupada recommends that one should offer some prayers to the holy name after the finishing of chanting. This is the book which yesterday I had told and 10 devotees wanted a copy. So, same book has been reprinted in this form because it's a little less expensive, less quality paper, but anyway, it's I think 80 rupees or something. So, there are 2-3 more, I mean, Prabhuji is getting next month, so can give the names. So, here there is a section where Prabhupada explains that how we should offer prayers to the holy name while we are chanting Hare Krishna. Especially, Prabhupada writes in the 7th canto, 5th chapter, that famous verse, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam. So, in that, Prabhupada writes that after one finishes his japa, then one should offer some prayers. Because, just like when you do deity worship, when one does deity worship, then we offer prayers. For those of you who are doing deity worship, you know, there are certain mantras to be chanted after we finish the offerings, after we finish the pujas, or when you wake up the Lord, then there are certain prayers. So those prayers are basically begging forgiveness for any offense. So similarly, Prabhupada writes in the 7th canto, 5th chapter, that same verse we discussed yesterday. Anybody knows what is that verse? Very famous verse. 7th canto means Prahlad. What verse was? Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu. Sugar Prabhu is very intelligent. Just need a little hint. Actually, we all need little pushing. And that pushing should not necessarily come from a person from outside. We should all push each other also. Just like today we are organizing this. We are trying to do 64, whatever we can do till 12:30. So I am pushing you a little bit. And many devotees have agreed. I am sure many of you also, after breakfast, we can chant little extra rounds. So I am pushing you. But this pushing is needed. Because even I am, although so-called senior, if I don't get any push, I will not move forward. So we have to push each other back to God. Prabhupada said, I am pushing you and you push others. We push each other back to God. Material world people push each other into the ditch of material life. Spiritual world we push each other closer to Krishna. So today being Saturday, many of you have holidays or you can go a little late or something like this. Please try to chant a little extra. Actually the plan according to the World Holy Name Week all over world, devotees are chanting extra rounds. I know some devotees are chanting 64 for the whole week. 64 into 7 means for more than 400 rounds. You know. So, according to our capacity, we have to try to chant more and more. So, one devotee asked Prabhupada that simply increasing the number, that is just quantity, but quality is also important. Prabhupada said, yes, that is true. But first, at least you do quantity, then we will talk about quality. So both go hand in hand. And also, this is the way of offering prayers. Like I was telling you yesterday about one devotee who is from US, now in Vrindavan, taking treatment. And this Mataji is about to, she's on the cancer, 4th stage. So obviously those who know her, or even those who don't know, but they have heard about her, they are praying. And what is the best form of praying? This Hare Krishna mantra is the best prayer. Hare Krishna mantra includes all the prayers of Lord Brahma, All the prayers of Prahlad Maharaj, all the prayers of Dhruva Maharaj, all the prayers of Queen Kunti. But because it is so simple, nobody takes it seriously. If I say, you know, I can memorize all Queen Kunti prayers, they are very nice, very impressive. Seminar on Queen Kunti's prayers, very nice. Even I take some time. But we should know that Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is all encompassing. Prabhupada says that actually when Dhruva Maharaj saw the Lord, he was so happy. The same, he was so surprised. He could not say anything. So he just chanted the name of Krishna. So how would you react? So when Gaurahari Prabhu, suppose Supreme Lord appears to you, just right when you are coming back from train on Bangalore railway station, Lord comes and gives you darshan, or gives you darshan in here in the ICC temple. What would you say to the Lord? Give me service. Give me service, yes. If you say Hare Krishna, you have said everything. That means give service also. That means purify me. That means, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, that there are many, many meanings of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. One of the meaning is, Hare means one who captures. Radharani's name is capture. So please capture my mind and connect it to Krishna. Please let me be attracted to Krishna's form, name, beauty. So if you just chant Hare Krishna, you have said everything. Vedicha, Ramayanicha, Itihasa, Purana. There are 4 Vedas, 18 Puranas, 108 Upanishads. All of them is contained in these 2 syllables. Hari, Hari. Hari, Hari, Hari. That is the samam bonam of all knowledge. And it looks so simple, we don't take it seriously. You have to tell you that the secret is there, but you need it, you know, you have to go and log in. Then it's a flash, like a flash sale, you know, mobile. Then a flash time you will get the secret, and you have to click, and then you type some password. Then you take it very seriously. But Hare Krishna Mantra is so easily available. We tend to neglect or not take it attentively. Although it is so simple, like Prabhupada said, one devotee asked Prabhupada, I am not able to chant. You said this process is very simple. Prabhupada said, yes, it is very simple, but not easy. Generally, we think simple and easy are synonymous. It is simple. Just like in computer logic, you write program, do I is equal to 1 to infinity, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Or do I is equal to infinity, 192 rounds. But we cannot chant. But one thing is, we fail to realize the importance of the holy name because it is so easily available. Like I know one of my friend, he is a doctor in Vrindavan, and he does service. Obviously there is some charges, so he decided one day a week I will give free service to the Brijavasis. Thursday, one day a week, say evening 5 to 7, so he put up a board for free service, and 3-4 weeks, nobody came. So then he was surprised. Then somebody told him, you put 50 rupees consultation charge. He put some charges, then there was a big line. People take seriously, yes, this person is. So, of course, Prabhupada is not charging us anything. And we are so fortunate. But we should not forget that this is the greatest wealth. Like, you know, this song is there, Hare Naam, Hare. What is that? Hare Naam, Ivakya. Madhuram, Madhuram, yeah. That is holy name. Oh, Dukkham. What is the greatest stress? That the jewel is being taken for a broken piece of glass. Material life is broken piece of glass. That we take as jewel. And Hare Krishna Mantra jewel we take. I'm not saying all of us do like that all the time, but sometimes it happens. You know? So we have to be very respectful to the holy name and chant with feeling of awe and veneration. As if you are meeting somebody very, very high, very advanced, you know. It is a fact. The Supreme Lord is all in all. So here, Prabhupada writes in the purport that even if you are committing offenses, we should not commit offenses. Every day we chant the 10 offenses. And unknowingly or knowingly, we do it also. So Prabhupada writes that even if you are committing offense, you should not stop chanting. He is quoting one book called Nama Kaumadi. That, suppose you do a Vaishnava Prad. Suppose I did some Vaishnava Prad to Gopinath Prandru, you know. Some like, he was coming late for class and chastised him. So now he's coming on time, almost, you know. So then later on I think, oh, I should not have chastised him. So what should I do? I should go and beg forgiveness. If you offend a Vaishnava, you beg forgiveness. And then he will forgive. And then he will again invite me for prasad and again come on time next time. So by begging forgiveness from a Vaishnava, the Vaishnava will forgive. You will not find any Vaishnava who says, no, I will not forgive you. Have you heard in history like that? Some Vaishnava says, no, Prabhuji, please forgive me. No, I will not forgive you. Go on suffering. Lord Chaitanya says like that. When Gopal Chappal offended Srivas Thakur, so Gopal Chappal begged forgiveness from Lord Chaitanya. Gopal Chappal was suffering so badly, he was literally in the roads like a beggar. His family members rejected him because he was suffering from such leprosy, so dangerous, it's contagious. Even family members rejected him. He was on the road, just like a beggar. And Lord Chaitanya happened to pass by. Gopal Chappal asked, my Lord, please, you are Patita Pavan. You are the deliverer of the most fallen. Please deliver me. Lord Chaitanya looked at him and said, suffer. You suffer for millions of years like this. This is my mercy to you. You are saying I am merciful. Yes, this is my mercy to you. So, Lord Chaitanya never forgives. When we offend a devotee, that devotee may forgive, but the Lord does not forgive. So then we have to go to the devotee and beg forgiveness. So many years later, again Lord Chaitanya came. And this time Lord Chaitanya was in a more compassionate mood after taking sannyas. He said, please forgive me. He said, okay, if you want to beg forgiveness, go to the person whom you have offended. So he went to Srivas Thakur. And Srivas Thakur said, there's no offense. It's forgiven. Amrish Maharaj, when Durvasa Muni offended him, Durvasa Muni was about to kill. Just see how false ego is. Durvasa Muni is also, the yogi. He's a spiritual person, advanced spiritual person, doing brahmacharya, tapasya. You know, Durvasa Muni is not like us taking three times Ekadashi Prasad. You know, he's a very strict brahmachari. But ego is more dangerous than even lust. So he became so angry. What was the offense of Amrish Maharaj? He just took some water. And that also he was waiting for him. You know. Here somebody drinks water, we don't even know. And somebody even goes outside and takes a little prasad and comes back also. We don't realize. But Durvasa Muni had such power, he could understand by his power that he has taken water. So he was so angry, he took out a hair from his body and fiery person came out. When somebody offends, he drank water. He could have said, Prabhuji, why do you drink water? Okay. Then Amrish Maharaj would have given him lemon juice. Okay, no, be peaceful. You know. But now he's so angry just because he drank water. See the contrast between a devotee and a yogi. A devotee like Haridas Thakur is so tolerant, so merciful, that even those who are killing him brutally with iron rods and spitting on him and dragging him on the streets, he's saying, forgive them. And Durvasa Muni, on the other hand, is so angry just because the devotee drank some water. So, of course, we should not offend Durvasa Muni also. He's also somewhat a devotee, the expansion of Lord Shiva. But pride is what makes a person. When you feel offended, that means you are proud also. Even if that other person is wrong, we should not take offense. If you are taking offense, that means it's something is lacking in me. It's wrong on his part to offend me, but it's wrong on my part to feel offended. Like Haridas Thakur would not feel offense. There are three kinds of reaction. One is suppose somebody is criticized or insulted, maybe because of his wrongdoing or because of just some conspiracy. So one reaction is immediately somebody insults you, just fire back, in kajava patthar se. War, verbal war. That is the lowest level. The second reaction, it could be that I understand that I am insulted. I feel bad also, but I tolerate it. Sometimes it is because I know from Shastra we should tolerate. Sometimes it is because I don't want my image to be spoiled. If I become angry, then, you know, then the other. So just out of desire to maintain dignity, I tolerate. But the highest level is like Haridas Thakur. When somebody told him, "I'll cut off your nose and ears," he did not even react. He said, "No problem. I'll cut off my own nose." And he didn't feel bad. It's like if there's a pus in the finger, some sore is there, if you touch it, there'll be pain. Now you can slap it off, nothing is happening. But if there is some pus, you just touch and it's so pain. A devotee who has ego, who is not yet pure, he feels insulted, there's pain. But a pure devotee who has no ego, there's no reaction. Of course, we should not go and trying other devotees. I want to test whether you have ego or not. We should be very humble, not offend devotees. But if somebody offends us, so Lord Chaitanya then told Gopal Chappal, "You go and beg forgiveness from Srivas Thakur." And he begged forgiveness, and Srivas Thakur forgave. But here, what we are discussing is something different. Here, Prabhupada is recommending in Bhagavatam that one should beg forgiveness from the holy name. The holy name is also a person, Shri Nam Prabhu. Like one very advanced devotee, one Babaji, he had a deity of the holy name carved in the stone. In the stone, you know, Hare Krishna is written. And he would do abhishek of that deity and worship that deity. So Hare Krishna mantra in itself is also a deity. The name and the named, both are non-different. The name Krishna and the person Krishna, they are non-different. But out of the two, who is more merciful? The name is more merciful. How can you say that the name is more merciful?
Anybody can chant that.
Everybody can chant anytime. No time limit. Like if you want to do puja in the temple, you have to be Brahman initiated. That also you can get chance once a week on Thursday. You know, you get chance to touch the deities. It's very fortunate, those who are able to do any deity worship. It's a direct contact with the Lord. You know? But at the same time, we should know the holy name is even more merciful. Anybody can chant the holy name. But here again, the reciprocation with the holy name will depend on the attitude of the chanter. Although we say the holy name is absolute, it is like fire. Whether you put your hand in the fire knowingly or unknowingly, the hand will burn. Similarly, if you chant the holy name knowingly or unknowingly, there is benefit. But if you want the full benefit, you chant the way Prabhupada recommends. So those of you who have not given your name for this book, please give. If you know, you can even, of course, I'm sure it's a small amount, but otherwise we can distribute also. I found so much improvement in my japa. I've been reading it for the last 2-3 years now. And not only you have to read it, but you have to practice it. That's a challenge. Every page of this book is revealing secrets. So here in this particular section which we are reading, Prabhupada is saying in the Bhagavatam purport that one should be very humble and meek to offer one's desire and chant prayers composed in glorification of the holy name. It's like here we have this Hare Krishna mantra written on this cloth. Sometimes in Pune temple recently we had inauguration. We have made one small altar of the holy name with the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is there. We offer puja to the holy name. So while we are chanting, we should be thinking mentally that I am worshipping the holy name. It's like if you are worshipping someone, then it is less likely that you will feel sleepy. If you are just repeating something which you are not interested, then you will feel sleepy. And it's like somebody just speaking something meaningless. But if you are knowing that this is not meaningless, this is the essence of all the Shastras. This is what Brahma and Narada are worshipping. The lotus feet is the holy name is worshipped by demigods. So if we are conscious of the greatness of the holy name, it's like the pujari, just now the puja was going on, the pujari is using the chamar. In fact, Kanchipuram, Ati Vardharaj deity, pujaris are fanning. Kanchipurna himself would fan during Ramanujacharya's time. But we never see or hear of some devotees fanning the Lord and he falls asleep. Have you seen some case like that? Very rare. Because you know, oh, this is... I mean, I remember last month I went, it was, this is September, August 6th, I was fortunate to get darshan. Any of you went there for darshan? It's all right, Pranapa. It's all right, Pranapa. Hari. That's all right. Hari. Has any of you, did any of you go for darshan? Oh, many of you went. You also? Yeah. Gopinath Prabhu, you did not go? You went? Mataji also went? You had darshan? Yeah, good. Those of you did not go, don't worry. 2039, 2059, next darshan is there. I pray and hope that all of you live till then. Or if we die, we can take birth in Kanchipuram. We are thinking of Lord. There's one lady, you know, you saw the video, she had darshan 3 times so far. You heard? She was there in 1839, then, 1939, 1979, and 2019. Did you see? The video, some Tamil lady, you know. She's old, must be minimum 80 years old because assuming she took first darshan when she was just born. She must have been at least 10 years that time. So now 90 years old. Actually, I was going to go and devotees told me too much rush, I cancelled. But then some devotee arranged a VIP pass. So I said, okay, I'll try. So for that darshan, when I could go because of this one devotee from Chennai, her husband is a commissioner. Police commissioner. So he arranged passes for many devotees. Chilaja Patakmar disciple. So because of that I could get darshan in like 45 minutes or half an hour, you know. So other devotees, I told other devotees, you can also come. Because I was told, bring as many people. So first I got 10, then I got 10, and then 10. And then later on devotees said, Prabhu Hari Bol, enough. So by the time devotees had booked their tickets, so they came and there was so much rush. They tried for VIP pass. For 4 hours they were in the VIP line. Then they went to the general line. And then it took 8 hours. So they went in the line at 12 o'clock. That also they broke the line half the way. So they could get darshan at 6 o'clock evening. So it's very nice, of course. Very purifying. The deity is so beautiful. But I was thinking in my mind that we spent 8 hours for a darshan of, you know, like maybe 30 seconds. You are in the VIP line, a general line. General line is, in one sense, more purifying because you wait more, you have more anxiousness. And, but actually, I went in the VIP line because VIP, I am a VIP, very insignificant person. So anyway, these devotees who went in the line at 12 o'clock, they really are absorbed. They are just waiting. Every moment they were chanting Hare Krishna. They finished 64 rounds in the line. And that is a great benediction also. If you just sit and chant 64, you cannot sit. Like today, we are suggesting that after breakfast, we sit. But I'm sure 50% will have other things to do, but whoever stays. But in the line, it's so purifying. But then I was thinking that the same deity of Varadaraja Swami, Ati Varadaraj, plus other regular Varadaraja Swami, plus Balaji and Jagannathji and Gopinathji and Shamsundarji and Radha Shamsundar, they are all in the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So when I am chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. So when I am chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, I am simultaneously having darshan of all. The whole Ras Mandal is there, the Vrindavan Dham is there, all the Gopas, the Gopis, Nanda Baba, Yashoda, they are all in the Hare Krishna Mantra. So how much more I should be respectful, even if it takes a little extra time. Like Prabhupada is recommending here to offer some prayers. Somebody may say, Prabhu, already it's taking me 6 minutes per mala, 1 hour, 36 minutes. And I have so many things to do. Now you are putting a GST on it, you know, a prayer after every mala. You know. But it's worth it. You will find the difference. Even I am not able to do all the time because depending on the schedule. But I try to do at least once a week, twice a week, that before the chanting, spend 5 minutes offering prayers or after the chanting, you know, then you will also feel that you are doing something worthwhile. You are doing something meaningful rather than just finish some rituals. It's like card punching. I'm with Krishna. It's 2 hours I'm with Krishna. Although we may not have any taste, we may not have any realization, but at least theoretically we know. So here are some of the prayers which are a little difficult, but you can try to repeat after me. And when you get the book, you can read it every day, at least once a day, if not more. This is from one song written by Rupa Goswami, which is called Namashtaka. Just like we have Shiksha Ashtaka, Guru Ashtaka, there are 8 verses, Lalita Ashtaka, Radhika Ashtaka, Krishna Ashtaka, Shachisut Ashtaka, you know, Ashtaka means 8 verses. So this Namashtaka, anybody knows which is that verse? Please repeat. Nikhila Shruti Mauli Ratnamala Dyuti Nirajita Pada Pankajanta Ai Mukta Kuler Upashiyamanam Paritastvam Harinama Samshrayami. Please repeat after me. O Harinam, the tips of the toes of your lotus feet are constantly being worshipped by the glowing radiance emanating from the string of gems known as the Upanishads, the crown jewel of all Vedas. You are eternally adored by liberated souls such as Narada and Shukadev. O Harinam, I take complete shelter of you. So here, the Upanishads are called the crown jewel of the Vedas. They are giving the Vedic knowledge in summary. So those Upanishads, they are also glorifying the holy name. The tips of the toes of your lotus feet, like Harinam Prabhu. Nam is a Prabhu, is lotus feet. So meditating on the lotus feet of Sri Harinam Prabhu. And second point is, they are worshipped by Narada and Shukadev. We hear in the song, Brahma Bole Chatur Mukhe, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Mahadeva Pancha Mukhe, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Brahma is chanting Krishna Krishna Hare, Rama Rama Hare. Even Narada Muni is chanting. Rupa Goswami is chanting. Sometimes we think chanting is good for me. It is a medicine. When I get cured, there is no need for medicine. Right? We take medicine when we are sick, antibiotics. But you don't find people taking antibiotics just like that. You know? But this is simultaneously a medicine for those who are not pure. When you become pure, it becomes a transcendental drink, a nectar, nectarian juice. In other words, chanting is going on even in the spiritual world. The gopis are constantly chanting Hare Krishna. Shukadev Goswami is chanting Hare Krishna. Haridas Thakur is not there after going back to Gwalior. He says, okay, drama is over now. I chanted one night enough, now let me take a break. You know, he is chanting there also. And Prabhupada said, wherever you are, you chant Hare Krishna, you will be united with your Guru Parampara. Prabhupada was leaving America to come to India, and devotees were crying, Yamuna Mataji and others. You know, so Prabhupada says, don't worry, I am chanting Hare Krishna, you are chanting Hare Krishna, so we are united. And this unites everyone. This is the only way the society can remain together, in spite of differences. Otherwise, how can, like, in material world, I remember when I was in college life, I was studying in Banaras Hindu University, so in the hostel. There is one hostel, but there is segmentation. All the students from South India, they would stay together. Students from Bihar and UP would be one group. Students from Maharashtra would be another group. Yeah? They would come together for classes, but for their meals and for their socialization, there would be differences. You know? So how can there be unity in ISKCON? We also have different languages. You know, we have different tastes, we have different spiritual masters, we have different, even in Krishna Leela, some people like some pastimes, people like Gauranga Leela, some people like Bhagavad Gita more. But what is common is everybody likes the Hare Krishna mantra. At least we understand the importance of the Hare Krishna mantra. Next verse is a little well known to you. Next verse which Prabhupada says we should offer after finishing chanting is Bhagavatam verse. Nivritta Tarishe Upagiyamana.
Nivritta
भवौषध श्रोत मनोभिरामात् क उत्तम श्लोक गुणानुवादात् पुमान विरज्यते विना पशुग्नात्. From the 10th canto, first chapter of Bhagavatam, the translation is like this. Descriptions of the Lord spoken by those who are free from material desires are the right medicine for the conditioned soul undergoing repeated birth and death, and they delight the ear and the mind. Therefore, who will cease hearing such glorification of the Lord except a butcher or one who is killing his own self? In other words, glorification of the Lord, chanting of the holy name, that is the medicine. Only of one who is pashugna, that means one who is killing animals or is killing himself, he will neglect such hearing and chanting. In other words, hearing and chanting is the life of a devotee. One who neglects, he is committing spiritual suicide. So oftentimes we find devotees, you know, they render devotional service for many, many years, do some good achievements, and then after a couple of decades or three decades, they leave the movement. You know. So, sometimes it is very depressing, and we start questioning the validity of the process. The Prabhupada was asked this question, and Prabhupada said, do not be surprised at who leaves, but be surprised at who stays. So, how can we stay if we are just very firmly fixed in the chanting of the holy name? Even if you do a lot of services, if the chanting is not good, then after some time you lose that attitude of service. But if one is chanting properly and sincerely taking shelter of the holy name, then one can remain strong in spite of the fierce storm of Maya. Like you find when the storm, so a year back I was in Shukrata near with the place where Bhagavatam was spoken, this place between Delhi and Haridwar, and there was, on the way there was a storm. Do you know, it happened 1 year back in North India, there was a big storm. And when, by Krishna's mercy, somebody warned us, so we were, you know, we stopped the car and we were halting in one place. When we came out in the evening, we saw so many big, big trees were uprooted, just fallen to the ground. But then there were some trees who were not uprooted. The trees whose roots were really down, 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 they were not uprooted. Same way when the storm of Maya comes, many devotees will get temporarily disconnected. Of course, they will come back. But those who are deeply rooted in the science of devotional service, as given by Rupa Goswami, given by the Acharyas, they will not be wounded. Okay. Before we move forward, any questions or any comments related to what we discussed? Is it about this verse? Huh?
So you said that gopis also chant around the world. What is the meaning that they are having at that time?
I have not heard what is the meaning they are meditating. Once maybe you go there, you can tell me. Let us just do whatever we can. It's a too esoteric subject to discuss here, what they are meditating this. We have to be on that. So better we just chant. Okay, anything else? Yes, Prabhu, Kiran, Prabhu.
Small note. We tell outside people that chanting, generally we tell it is for mind control. We tell we can control the mind. But we find that after starting chanting, it's very difficult for the mind. So it's very contradictory.
Prabhupada is asking that we take seminars on mind control and tell people we should chant Hare Krishna. Then we ourselves are not able to control the mind. It looks contradictory. The fact is that what we are talking about, the mind control, is a ultimate stage of chanting. The mind starts relishing the holy name. Till the point we relish the holy name, it will be a struggle. But as far as the other people who are not into Krishna consciousness, they already surrendered to Maya. So then, for sometimes the mind, as I told yesterday, if a prisoner is very obedient, prisoner is just wanting to stay in the prison in charge will not be putting much restrictions on him. But if the prisoner is trying to escape, then there will be attempts to block him, to stop him. If you are not chanting Hare Krishna, if you are chanting very leisurely, you know, like take it easy, 4 morning, 4 afternoon, 4 evening, and 4 in the bedroom, you know, Kirtaniya Sadhari. So, so Mayadevi will also understand, Hare is apna yadmi, you know, he is our man, but he is in ISKCON, but Amari Varsab, obedient servant of Mayadevi. That is also, you know, you can think, I am servant of servant, Maya is servant of Krishna, and very tricky. The Mayadevi will not trouble you. But when you try to chant nicely, you try to do sincere service, then Mayadevi will disturb. It's like now we are sitting here, lecture is not so much problem. Now we are planning a session after breakfast. First of all, half the devotees, Mayadevi will say, go out, you know. I'm just going out for a break, I'll be back in half an hour, you know. I mean, I'm not criticizing those who are going away, but I am indirectly encouraging you to stay. So, then even if you, those who stay, the mind will wander. I mean, see, if you are a Paramahansa, then you can be peaceful in chanting. And we are not Paramahansa, we are not even Hansa. At least I am not. Hansa means you can separate milk from water. So what to do? We have to keep on struggling. It's like we say, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. But the small star there, like you see in Bangalore, that flat, 1,000 square feet flat available for just 5 lakh rupees. Immediately go for booking. And there's a small star there, you know. There's installments, this is, and then EMI and so on. So we have a small star, chant Hare Krishna and be happy star, bracket, eventually. And you become completely purified. This is my understanding, maybe other devotees can. Ashok would like to add something. Gopinath Pran Prabhu. Okay, any Matajis would like to add or ask any questions? Okay, we'll.
Someone said that chant Hare Krishna, then struggle and then
Hare Krishna, that's a good addition, yes. Actually, why there is struggle is also, it is just a means of Krishna making us more sincere. You know? It's like why there are tests in school and colleges. You know, you can just have the student go from one grade to another without the study is the same. Why there are tests? Because one advantage of test is that coaching classes have some business. Otherwise, what will people do in coaching classes, you know? I'm encouraging people. But the main reason why there are tests is to make the students more sincere. Because if the option is given that you can take test or need not take test, you know, how many will take test? Nobody will take. Nobody is intelligent will take. So Mayadevi, this Mayadevi is not some demon. She is a Vaishnavi. She is very kind. She is expansion of Radharani. But she has to put the test just so that to make you more sincere and to separate the sincere from the insincere. So all of this, when you go back to God, it will look like a small, like I was in a drama. And some obstacles were there, and then you look from Krishna at the top and you say, oh, there are still some people struggling in South Bangalore, just see, you know, you'll be with Krishna. So everything you'll forget. Just like, you know, once the examination is over, you pass, you get a degree, then it's all over. And it's joyful. So once we go back to God, it'll be joyful. The struggle is very short term. And how short the period is depends on your sincerity. Once Prabhupada was asked this question, how much time it takes to become pure devotee? You have seen that video? It came on, it was viral on WhatsApp, you know. What did Prabhupada say? Prabhupada said it. He did like this, one moment. It's one holy name. That is why I am encouraging. Now many people think, and it's true also, that I do not know other Shastra, that is true. But one reason why I encourage is, because this is the essence. And if you can concentrate on this, you will go back to Godhead. I suppose you cannot get much knowledge of the creation, the fifth canto, how the world is, universe is there, you know, 14 planetary systems, how the hellish planets are organized and everything, how the heavenly planets are there. Even if you don't know that, if you chant nicely, you will go back to Godhead. What is important? To study the complete geography of the jail and where the facilities are there, or to get out of the jail? Get out, you know. So, of course, Bhagavatam gives a description, and if we are intelligent, we should read that also. But in the process, we should remember that. Main thing is, find out the jail, where are the rooms, where are AC rooms, where the food is stored in the jail, what time the rasgulla is given, But more importantly, when the door will open. And I said, just rush out, you know. Shri Balaji Prabhu is sitting behind, so just can rush. I'm just giving an example, you know. So while we are in the material world, our eyes should be focused at the time of death, you know. Every time you should be thinking that is, any time Krishna may call me. And I will just run and say, Hare Krishna. Oh, I have some service to do, Krishna will take care. Some money, Krishna will take care. My family members, they are all Krishna's family members. So he said, just be ready. Just ready at any moment to give up the present body and go to wherever Krishna. If Krishna says go back to God, that is good. If Krishna says no, you come back and do some more service, that is also good. What do you prefer, Swami Prakash Prabhu? Going back to Godhead or coming back here? Huh? Going back to Godhead. What about you, Sri Balaji Prabhu? Whatever Krishna wants. You know what I think? It's a very strange thing. I got an idea that I would. I told you once, I would like to go back to Godhead and meet all the acharyas there. Because Rupa Goswami there, Sanatana Goswami, Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta. And they will ask, I'll ask me, Hari Bol, surprise, how did you come here? Then I will mention my spiritual master and all the devotees, their mercy. And then offer pranam to them and immediately come back. Yeah? Come back and then preach. Because there is one pleasure you don't get in the spiritual world. And that is the Bhavananda, the pleasure of preaching in this material world. The spiritual world, you don't have to, I mean, whom will you preach to? You know, you say, you are not the body, soul. No, my soul is same as body. In the gopi's body, is same as soul. You'll tell them, remember Krishna. Gopis are saying, my God, we are crying whole day for Krishna. We are not able to forget. And you are telling us, remember Krishna. There's no need of beatbacks there, you know. You're naturally remembering. So that Prabhupada actually once told, somebody asked him where you would like to come again. If Prabhupada said, I would like to go to the hellish planets, preach there also. And once he said, my favorite place of preaching is New York. The New York is something like that. All the big cities. But once Prabhupada was traveling in New York on a morning walk and he saw some filthy area, some dirty area, and then devotees were like, Prabhupada said, if you have eyes to see, you will see here also Vrindavan. The Prabhupada was experiencing Vrindavan everywhere. Because tavar dekhe, jangam dekhe, na dekhe, taram murti. Sarvatra hai, ishta deva smriti. Everywhere you see your Lord Krishna, Gopinath, Jagannath. Okay, so we'll move a little forward on this. Now, we will go back to the Chaitanya Charitamrita verse. We started with 20, 21. Now the next verse, 20 we did, 21st verse, we'll do it again for some devotees joined later, so we will read that verse. Hare Nama, Hare Nama,
Hare Nama,
Hare Nama,
Kevalam,
Kalo Nastieva, 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 Gatir Anyatha. Yes, Shri Gopinath Prabhu, please read that translation.
In this age of Kali, there is no other means for self-realization than chanting the holy name. Chanting the holy name, chanting the holy name of Lord Hari.
Yeah, so this is actually the most important verse in all the Shastras. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was talking to Prakashananda Saraswati, he told that my Guru Maharaj told me this verse is the most important. The interesting story of, you know, who is the first person who got initiated by Lord Chaitanya? Anybody knows? Tapan Mishra. Those from Suratkal remember. Tapan Mishra was a Brahmin in Varanasi. And he had read all the Vedic literatures and he was thoroughly confused. He wanted to know what is the goal of life and how to achieve that goal. He was confused, reading too many books, like a bookworm. And then he had a dream. A dream when Brahmana directed him. Go and meet Nimai Pandit. And Nimai Pandit will guide you. So he went to Nimai Pandit. Nimai Pandit at the time was on a tour, on an educational tour. He was giving grammatical knowledge. And he was in Bangladesh, East Bengal. He just finished his classes. And many people were coming to him and giving donations. He met Lord Chaitanya secretly and asked him, what is the goal of life? How to attain? Lord Chaitanya told him, I will tell you, but don't disclose it to others because my time has not come for my preaching. The goal of life is to develop love for Krishna. The means is chanting of the holy name. So he told this verse, Hare Nami Vakim. And then he said, I will give you the mantra, the 16-word, 32-syllable Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. This 32-word, 32-syllable mantra. He told him, don't disclose it to anybody. This was the first recorded instance where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu initiated someone. He told him to keep it a secret. Now we go to the next verse. Kalikale nama rupe Krishna avatara.
Kalikale nama rupe Krishna avatara.
Nama hai te hai sarva jagat nistara. And if the Mataji would like to read. It's a very, very instructive verse also. Kalikale naam rupe. There are different avatars. Varaha avatar, Ram avatar, Krishna avatar. But this is naam rupe avatar. As I told earlier, naam is more merciful than the named. And naam haite hai sarva jagat nistar. Just by chanting the holy name, one will be delivered. There's no need for any other process, any purashcharana, any prayaschit, atonement. But there's one story in Chaitanya Charitamrita that one devotee had gone to Varanasi. Actually, he was from Varanasi and he had done some mistake and he was trying for atonement. Anybody knows the story? Ah, yeah. What is the name of the devotee? I also forget. Huh? Subuddhira, yes. And Prakash Prabhu has regular dry fruits in the morning, almonds, a good memory. So, Subuddhi Rai, he was a nice person. But what happened is, when the Nawab Hussain Shah, who later on became the king of Bengal, earlier he was coming from a very poor family and he was doing the job of digging, like you find people on the construction site, you know, they have to dig, he was digging a well. And it was under the guidance or the supervision of Subuddhi Rai. As he was not doing his duty properly, Subuddhi Rai just, like sometimes you slap your child, or he just took a whip and just, take care of, do it nicely. So those marks were there on his body. And later on he became the king. And one day his wife saw the mark and she asked, what is this marks? Who did it? Who dared do this to you? So he said, not a big deal, it's just like, you know, Subuddhi Rai, he did it, he's like my father, he did. No, you should be punished. He said, no, forget it, no, you have to punish. I am saying, you know, if you are staying in the home, you have to listen. So he had to, this is anadikal going on, you know. So he had to give some punishment. So he said, kill him. No, killing is too strong a punishment. Okay, convert him into a Muslim. So at that time, this is how Indian, many people in India were converted. Sometimes by force, sometimes by offering material allurements like money, or sometimes by just, they would have a pitcher of water, they would carry that water and just throw it. Musalman bhava, you know, like that. And that person was. So he was just, the water was thrown and all the Brahmins rejected him. He was not allowed to enter into any home. He said, what is my fault? I was just walking and somebody threw water, you know. He said, no, you have to do prayaschit. Yes, I will do any prayaschit. Please tell me, what should I do? Drink hot ghee. What will that do? You will die. In the next birth, you will be Brahmana. So, he was thinking, this is not a very easy process, you know. Somebody says, you know, like, you have got this liver problem. What should I do? Take poison then. You will get a new body. New liver, new kidney, you know. This is not a recommended process. I mean, essentially Buddhism is like that. I mean, just destroying oneself. So he came to some brahmanas, consulted. There was no unanimous opinion. And he came to Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya said, no need of ghee, no need of drinking ghee. Just go to Vrindavan and chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So he went to Vrindavan, started chanting constantly. And for his livelihood, he would get some wood, cut some wood from the neighborhood and transport the wood and then sell it in the market. And whatever profit he would get, he would use most of it for serving the Vaishnavas, in fact, all of it. How would he serve the devotees? Bengali devotees he would bring? Rice and?
Curd.
Curd, yes. In the Bengalis, they like rice. I remember in Mayapur, I was sitting, taking prasadam. And, you know, we take one or two spoons, but next to me, there were some nice Bengali devotees. They had like big Gordan hill. Yeah. Then Radha Kund in between. Yeah. And Odisha also, Odisha devotees there. They like rice. And so Bengali, I mean, generally, typically, they don't take chapatis. And in Vrindavan, all you get was chapatis, rotis, not chapatis. Roti means like thick. You have to be thick to digest also. And Bengalis are skinny. So they had health problems. So he would serve them rice mixed with curd. It's a very good diet for anybody having stomach disorders. Lord Chaitanya had once, you know this problem? Lord Chaitanya went to the home of Shivananda Sen. And Shivananda Sen served him too much. Because Shivananda Sen was senior devotee. So even Lord Chaitanya could not resist, you know. So he had stomach disorder. And next day, Shivananda Sen's son, whose name was? There was Puri Das also, Chaitanya Das also, and the third one was Kavikarnappa. But it was Chaitanya Das who invited for Prasad. Haride Prabhupada remembers all the Prasadam related stories. So Chaitanya Das invited the Lord. And he got some rice and yogurt. The Lord was very happy. So, especially South India, this is a very common preparation to Andhra Pradesh or even here. So, the point being made is for deliverance from any sin, even we should not do it. But somebody even has unknowingly been involved in the murder of a brahmana or some very sinful activity, the chanting of the holy name will free him. Because we should try not to even think of such activity. But such is the power of the holy name. But one should not perform the sinful activities and then atone and then again perform. You know, that is called Namnat Balad Yasya Papa Buddhi. Performing sinful activities on the strength of the holy name. That is very risky. Unknowingly, whatever we have done, the holy name will forgive. But we should not intentionally do any sinful activity. Okay. Next verse. Dadya lagi harer nama ukti tina vara jada loka bujai te puna eva kara. Shri Balaji Prabhu can read.
This verse repeats the word eva certainly three times for emphasis, and it also three times repeats Hare Nama, the holy name of the Lord, just to make common people understand.
Please read the purport.
To emphasize something to an ordinary person, one may repeat it three times, just as one might say, you must do this, you must do this, you must do this. Thus, the Brihannadaya Purana repeatedly emphasizes the chanting of the holy name, so that people may take it seriously and thus free themselves from the clutches of Maya. It is our practical experience in the Krishna consciousness movement all over the world that many millions of people are actually coming to the spiritual stage of life simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra regularly, according to the prescribed disciplines. Therefore, our request to all our students is that they daily chant at least 16 rounds of this Hare Nama Mahamantra, offenselessly, following the regulative principles, thus their success will be assured without doubt.
There are two important points in this purport. The first is three times. Three times to emphasize. Like we say, you know, you do this, you do this. Or you come at 8 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 8 o'clock. It doesn't work something. But anyway, we keep emphasizing. So emphasis is done. Repetition is a way of emphasizing something. We emphasize that, you know, you should. That tomorrow is now Ekadashi, Wednesday is Ekadashi. We say sometimes two, three times to emphasize. That is one point. And second point, Prabhupada is saying that We request devotees to chant the Maha Mantra offenselessly. Their success will be assured. But Prabhupada is saying, he's not saying that you have to do a particular service. Just chanting the holy name will bring all success. Now you may ask, does that mean we should neglect the services? The services are not different from the chanting. If you have whatever service you are doing, that is also part of chanting. But we should have exclusive time for chanting also. There are two extremes. One extreme is to think that, oh, chanting is everything, so I neglect all my spiritual and worldly duties. Another extreme is to just become so engrossed in the duties that we have no time for actually chanting attentively. Then 16th round become just like time crumbling in a box, you know, like last minute arrangement just to fulfill the, till the 12 o'clock in the night we are struggling to chant the 14th round, you know. So we have to avoid the extremes and try to remain balanced, chanting and service. Without proper service attitude, the chanting is like firing without gunpowder, you have a pistol, the sound is coming, but there is no Namakshar hai, Krishna nahi hai. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says in Harinam Chintamani, if we don't have the proper attitude, the Nam Akshar hai, but Krishna nahi hai. The syllables is coming out, but Krishna is not appearing. So you have to balance these two things. Okay, we'll go to one more verse. Is everybody able to follow? The speed is very fast or slow, or is it okay? Any questions or in between? Okay, we'll read one more verse. Kevala Shabda Punarapi Nishchaya Karana Jnana Yoga Tapa Karma Adi Nivarana. Obstinacy.
It is the injunction of the sastras. You must not deviate from the injunctions of the sastras. This is confirmed in the next verse of the Chaitanya
Charitamrita. So Prabhupada is saying that three things are neglected, I mean three things are negated: karma, jnana and yoga. Anya vilashita shunyam jnana karma dhyanavritam. According to Shripad Rupa Goswami, pure devotional service means be free from the tinges of jnana and karma. That's why three times nasti, nasti means not by karma, not by jnana, not by yoga, only holy name. And then when we tell others, this is the only way, sometimes they become angry and some of them they say, Swamiji, you are good, we are also good. I am okay, you are okay. So we say, no, we are good, you are not good. Now this may look like pride. Nahi? Suppose I say, yes, my class is also good and Surnagari Prabhu's class is also good. Yeah, he is a nice devotee. But suppose I say, my class is good, but his class is bogus. Just for the sake of saying. Then it looks like pride. But why is Prabhupada saying like this? That we are right, they are wrong. Just to separate gold from imitation gold. Suppose I am selling pure gold. That is costing like 35,000 rupees for 10 grams, something like that. Right? Somebody told me in a lecture, something to that extent. Another person, like suppose somebody is selling imitation gold, suppose Sri Balaji Prabhu, for example, 3,500 rupees for 10 grams. So obviously everybody will think, oh, this is also gold, that is also gold. Don't try it because you will be in trouble. So everybody will go there and they will get cheated. So I have to tell him, no, I will tell, this is gold, that is imitation gold. You can go there, but you will not get the real thing. Now, what the other person who is selling imitation gold, he will say, yes, yes, both are good, both are good, because he wants to sell his product. But one who is having the real thing, he can say, you know. Somebody who is not breaking the law, he says, I'm okay. That this person who is a thief is a thief. The thief will say, no, I am also good, he is also good. Yeah, because he wants to avoid. The same way, the yogis, jnani will say, I am good, you are good. I will press my nose, float up in the air, that is yoga. You know, some people think yoga means pressing the nose, taking air inside, outside, anulom, vilom. That is simply bodily yoga. There is nothing to do with bhakti yoga. You may do like this and in the next birth have a different nose and then keep doing like this. You know? Yeah. You may live a little longer also. It can actually help in elongating one's lifespan with good healthy. So devotee may take help of yoga, but knowing that this is only a vehicle for the actual. Just like we have a gold, and the gold may be kept in a nice box. So the box is needed. But if somebody just gives you the box and doesn't give you the gold, then it's being cheated. So this Hatha Yoga and Jnana, these are external covers. But the real thing is bhakti. And we are so fortunate that we have come directly to ISKCON where pure bhakti is being distributed. Of course, there are other sampradayas also. Some of them are bona fide. But most people in Kali Yuga are being misguided. In the name of spirituality, they get some material things like yoga. And so our style is that even if somebody is interested in yoga, gradually we bring them to bhakti yoga. Then that is the real yoga. Like once Prabhupada was walking down the road and he saw somebody doing yogasana and Prabhupada said, see, he's wasting his time, wasting his life. Next day again Prabhupada was walking, he saw somebody else doing like that and one devotee said, Prabhupada, he's wasting time. Prabhupada said, no, he's preparing for spiritual life. Because it depends on why you do that yogic exercise. Okay, we'll go a little fast. My desire is that we'll end by 10 and then after breakfast, how many of you would like to join? We have a special japa session and we will just at the end we'll chant one round so that gives a little introductory boost and take prasad as much as you like but as less so that you can come back in a waking state. Generally my suggestion is, you know, take. If you want to do 64 rounds, or not 64, but at least till 12:30, whatever we can do. We can at least finish 32 rounds. That will be an achievement also. So take light, not very heavy, and then chant at least till 12:30, then we can, and then during the day. These 3-4 days are, Holy Name Week is till 23rd, 24th. That means we have 3 more days. Today is already 21st. So if we can do at least 32 for the next 3 days, it will be a great achievement. And I'm encouraging you because whoever encourages, he also gets commission. So 50 devotees, out of 50, 25 may do 32 rounds. So 25 into 32 is, you know, it's a big, I get so much commission. Okay, shall we read little more? Anyatha je mane tare nahi ka nistara. Nahi 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 eiti na eva kara. Yes, Mahavir Prabhu, please read.
This verse clearly states that anyone who accepts any other path cannot be delivered. This is the reason for the triple repetition, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else, which emphasizes the real process of self-realization.
The triple repetition is emphasizing the real process. Same thing is being repeated. Trina hai te nicha hai sada labhe nama. Apani nirabhimani anne dibamana. Gaur Hari Prabhu.
To chant the holy name always, one should be humbler than the grass in the street and devoid of all desires for personal honor. One should offer respect others, all respect to others.
Here now, gradually Lord Chaitanya is coming to Trinadapi Sunichena. First he is saying the meaning of humility, next verse he will talk about tolerance. And then come to Trinadapi Sunichi. This is a very difficult quality, to become humble than a blade of grass. Even to become humble like a grass is difficult, but here it is said humbler than the grass. The grass is, people spit on the grass, sometimes people step on the grass. The grass is not protest. Do you find grass filing a complaint that this fellow, he is spitting on me, he is abusing me? And another quality Prabhupada says, you should give all respects and do not expect in return. Sometimes we give respect and then we say, is he giving or not? I give and he is just standing such. And next time I will also not give. I am not a cheap person. You know? So we give respects hoping that others will offer respects. That is not the perfect consciousness. Perfect consciousness is amani namanani. Like Sanatana Goswami is example of humility. Now we come to the next quality. Tarusama sahishnata vaishnava koribe. Barsana tadane ka ke kichuna bolibe. Same Prakash Prabhu. Yeah, the tree, sometimes people cut the tree and then they become tired. They take rest under the same tree and they eat the fruit of that tree. The tree is giving its fruits, the best part of its body for those who are trying to kill it. So this is a very, very difficult quality. And then later on Prabhupada will reveal how we will get this quality. Even if rebuked or chastised, you should not retaliate. Even if you are rebuked without reason, sometimes we are rebuked, chastised because something is wrong with us, but still we retaliate. But even if there is nothing wrong, if you are chastised, a devotee should tolerate. So that is the example of Haridas Thakur. He was beaten in 22 marketplaces for no reason except he was preaching. And yet he did not protest. Even although he did not ask for help, the Lord sent the Sudarshan Chakra to protect Haridas. But Haridas Thakur negated the help. He said, I don't want this help. I would rather die rather than cause inconvenience to others. This is a very high level of tolerance. Once it is said that one knows the greatness of a person by his ability to tolerate provoking situations. You like to read, Prabhuji? Next verse. Katila taru jena kichuna bolaya. Shukiya mareta bujalana magaya.
For even if one cuts a tree, it never protests. And even if it is drying up and dying, it doesn't ask anyone for water.
Means a tree, if somebody gives water, okay. If no water, okay. If somebody just cuts the tree, no protest. This is how we should aspire to be. Somebody gives some prasad, it's okay. Doesn't give, it's all right. No demanding. Sometimes for health reason we may have to ask, but it should be in the mood of a beggar, in the mood of a humility. You know? Of course, in the business world, we have to be practical. You know, devotee is asking, Prabhuji, if I become very humble and tolerant, they will take away everything from me. If you go outside and say, I have some money, this is my credit card number and my PIN, please, anybody wants. So then all your money will get exhausted. We can't be foolish. If somebody comes to cheat, we may have to fight. Somebody attacks you, then you may have to defend yourself. There are two kinds of devotees if we are attacked. Some may fight that this body is Krishna's property. I need this body for doing bhakti. So I'll fight with whatever weapons I have. Another devotee says, okay, Krishna will protect me. So both are perfect in their own ways. You know, like in Mayapur, once there was an attack by the Muslims, devotees have to fight. This Bhakti Raghava Maharaj gave up his leg fighting, you know, the devotees have to take up the gun. So, you have to be practical also. If the community is in danger. I remember in New Vrindavan, it happened once in America, and some demons came and they took the community leader and they just took him far away and said, dig your grave here, we are going to kill him. And simultaneously, some of the people came to the altar to take the deities. And all the devotees were like, now what to do? They did not want to give up the deities, although their life threat was there. And suddenly the deities, Radharani's deity just the big sound, the deity fell. The sound was so great, it fell to several long distance where the other demons were there who was going to kill the community leader. They all ran away, everybody ran away. So this deity, they told Prabhupada about this, the deity had a crack. And then the devotees told that Prabhupada will have to replace the deity. Prabhupada said, no, just you can just put some repair work. This deity's, Radharani's love for her devotees. She was willing to fall down just to protect her devotees. So we should not change the deity. Then this deity was, some repairs were done and the deity is still being worshipped. Anybody been to New Vrindavan in America? You have seen this deity. Radhanath Maharaj was pujari there many, many years. And about 84 to 87, I would also occasionally visit and sometimes Dwarati also. Because after Dwarati, there was nice milk prasad was there. So we have to be practical. Both are perfect. Depends on one's nature. Like Hanumanji is very kind, very tolerant. But when Mother Sita is in danger, or when Ravan is criticizing Ram, he becomes like fire. He burned the entire city of Lanka to ashes. And that also, all the expense of burning came from Ravan's account, because he is the one who put the oil in the tail. You know? So, like bombing the enemy with the enemy's bomb. So that is Hanumanji. And obviously he had to be angry. You can't set a building to fire out of lovingly. Hari Bol. You can't shoot arrows very lovingly. Arjuna is shooting arrows. He's like, Karna, be careful, otherwise you'll meet Yamaraj today. And so he's angry like fire. Bhima is remembering the insults of the Draupadi, and then he's beating up Dushasan, drinking his blood. That is, you cannot say that is not, that is like, why is he becoming angry? He should say, oh, okay, Hari Bol. So you are also part of Krishna. And at that time, anger was needed. So this verse should be understood in proper balance, not one way. Okay. Who read the translation, last one? Prabhuji read. Another. Purport, you would like to read the purport?
Ashwini. This practice of forbearance, arose was Sahishnuna, is very difficult. But when one actually engages in chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, the quality of forbearance automatically develops. A person advanced in spiritual consciousness through the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra need not practice to develop it separately. For a devotee develops all good qualities simply by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra regularly.
This last point is very important. Just by chanting Hare Krishna, all good qualities. Prabhupada says it's difficult. I remember before coming to ISKCON, I would go to various religious institutions. Sometimes, you know, Monday Chinmayananda, Tuesday Ramakrishna, like I was searching for the path. So in one of the institutes, they would tell you to, you know, to write how you control, like they would give a diary. So Monday, this 1 week I'll practice controlling anger. Another week I will control my envy, like that. You know, next week I'll control my lust. And after 6 weeks, all six would come again. Because it's not the recommended process. They're just like by self-restraint. Oh, I will not be angry. I will not be angry. I will be tolerant. But how long it will go on? But here, if you chant Hare Krishna, automatically all good qualities will come. Now you may say, Prabhuji, but I've been chanting for 10, 20, 30 years, but still I become angry. And I, not only me, this other devotee, I've been seeing him for 2 decades. And still he becomes angry when he doesn't get Mahaprasad. You know. So what to do? So we have to be patient then. According to the sincerity, we are making gradual or rapid spiritual advancement. So we should not be disappointed. Just like if you are in the hospital, you are taking treatment, still the disease is getting cured, but not fully. So what you do if you want to get cured? You take higher dose. Okay, the material world, if you take higher dose, it may not be good. Doctor says take 2 tablets a day for 1 week. So you take 42 tablets together, then Ram Naam Satya Hai, that will last day. But a devotee, if he says, okay, generally I chant 16, but today is Holy Name Week, let me chant 64. So then once in a while like this, heavy dose is good. There are no side effects of chanting. Have you heard somebody had some stomach problem or vomiting, too much chanting? Too much prasad may be a problem. Like Prabhupada, was one devotee wrote a letter to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, I am a brahmachari, but I am having a lot of lusty desires. It is disturbing my spiritual life. Prabhupada said, if the temperature is not reducing, if you have high temperature, then increase the dose. You take a higher dose. And then if you are feeling more lust, then instead of 16, try to chant 20, 25 every day. As per the, you know, timing available. Then grihastha ashram, you may not get extra time. But I have seen grihastha devotees like Bhakti Vinod Thakur. He was chanting 64 rounds. Plus he was doing 8 hours of his court duties also. So not that he was simply staying in ashram. You know, he was working also. plus he was writing books, plus he was meeting people, he was managing 350 Namahatta programs. So, you know, grihastha devotees have no excuse. Bhaktivinoda Thakur example is there. Brahmacharis have no excuse. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur's example is there. So, of course, we can never come close to their level, but we can follow in their footsteps. Okay, we read one more verse. Ei mata vaishnava kare kichu na magiba. Ayachit vritti kim va shaka phala khaiba. Govinda Sundar Prabhu, like to read. Just like 9 or 10 o'clock, there will be prasadam. Suppose prasadam is over, by the time you go, then you should Hare Krishna. Of course, there is prasadam, but suppose it happens like that, we go late, nothing is there. So, one thing is to become angry, then it's okay. Oh, same way. Now, those of you who are housewives, you have to make practical arrangements. You can't say, okay, I will wait some vegetables somebody will throw from the roof and I will cook that. No, you have to make arrangements. But that arrangement should be in a very simple manner. One should not go out of the way to get something very fancy just to please the tongue. Bhalana khaiba, bhalana puriba applies to all ashram. They don't taste very, very, not very tasty food. Once in a while it's all right. But whatever is easily available, that is the principle. Like in the temple, so it comes, we accept it. In the home also, whatever comes easily and satisfied. And we should not expect. When we expect, suppose I expect that in this home I will get malpua and pizza and pakoda, then I become disappointed. But if I don't expect anything and I get a simple khichdi, I am happy, yes, something. Asha hi param dukkha, nirasha se param sukha. When you expect something, you become disappointed. If you don't expect anything, then. Okay. Maybe one of the Matajis can read now. Sada nama laibe yatha labete santosha. Eite achara kare bhakti dharma posha. This particular section of Chaitanya Charitamrita, which I call Mahaprabhu's seminar, is actually the heart of all Bhakti Yoga. Even if you cannot attend other classes, I mean, you should attend, but suppose you do not remember. But this part, if you remember, what the last few minutes, last 1 hour we have been discussing, then you will go back to Godhead. Just if you learn this one thing, what is that? Strictly follow the principle of always chanting the holy name. The Prabhupada doesn't say, sometimes follow the principle of sometimes chanting. Strictly follow always chanting. Sometimes people always, you know, kind of joke, or they ask people, why are you always saying chanting, chanting? But Prabhupada is saying like this. See, the words are very strong. He says, one should strictly follow the principle of always chanting the holy name. In other words, it's not, we may be chanting 16 rounds now, but at least the goal should be to come to constant chanting. And that the step of that is that once in a month, I was requesting Ashok Gaur Prabhu to take the lead, you know, that once a month we have, like today we are going to chant till noon, you know, we can do one, like today is what, the fourth Saturday, or third Saturday, next, we can keep it second Saturday or fourth Saturday. Many people have holidays on second or fourth, you know, we have holiday that time, so maybe you can make it second Saturday for your convenience, you know. So Gopinath Pran Prabhu and Ashok Gaur Prabhu, you know, I'm requesting them. Unless you make a decision to do it, you will never do it. If you say, okay Prabhuji, when I get time, I will do it. No. We have to say, no, I will do it. Just like today, if I were not taking this class, then, you know, by now class would have been over. You know, but some other works will keep. But today said, no, out of respect for me, let us go and listen. The same way, out of respect for Lord Chaitanya, let us try to make an attempt once a month. How many of you feel we can do it once a month? There are three choices, once a month, twice a month, or four times a month. I'm learning some selling tricks, you know. Shall begin with once a month? Is that, Murli Prabhu, you agree? Is it possible? Mataji, is possible like that? What is good, like Saturday or Sunday? Saturday is better or Sunday? Saturday? Second Saturday, I would say. Because after this, also I am inviting all of you. We are planning a small trip to Melkote on 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th of October. That's the Dashera time. You may come for 1 day, 2 day or 3 days. Just for chanting. And of course, prasadam will be there. And little Gaur Katha. It is easier to chant if you are outside your home and like away from the place. You should be in a place where you cannot immediately go back. You should be transcendentally kidnapped, you know. And preferably in a place where the signals are not working, you know. So you are. And if somebody tries to call you, he says, out of range. They call you, don't pick up, you feel bad. So, it's out of range. Or you can put it in flight mode. You know, this is not out of envy or out of this. For self-preservation, for self-advancement. And think, just like, why do we send children to school? They can study at home also, the books are there. But school creates an environment, a favorable environment, where everybody is focused on one type of learning. This type of chanting is very helpful. And I thank Haridev Prabhu, he is the one who proposed this mini Melkote Yatra, just for chanting. Okay, shall we read one more verse? Trinadapi sunichena taror eva sahishnuna amani namanadena kirtaniya sadahari. Nandanacharya Prabhu, would like to read.
One who thinks himself lower than the grass, who is more tolerant than the wheat, and who does not expect personal honor, yet is always prepared to give all respect to others, can very easily always chant the holy name of the Lord.
Please read the purport.
The grass is specifically mentioned in this verse because everyone tamples upon it, yet the grass never protests. This example indicates that a spiritual master or leader should not be proud of his position, being always humbler than an ordinary common man. He should go on preaching the cult of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by chanting the Hare Krishna.
Here it is said, spiritual master or preacher should be more humble than common men. If somebody is a preacher or a counselor or a Namahatta leader, should be more humble. And this verse is so important. You will find in the next verses, Lord Chaitanya says, you should put this verse around your neck like a kanti mala. And he says, I raise my arms and declare that this is the most important verse. So this principle of Trinadapi suni chena, tarorapi sahishnana, amani na mana denak. Srila Prabhupada's Guru Maharaj, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he would say, this is our Siddha Pranali mantra. You know what is Siddha Pranali mantra? Like some Babaji is in Radhakund, they say that I have a Siddha mantra I will give you. So within 1 week, you will come to know who you are in the spiritual world. You are a gopi or a gop or a peacock. You know, sometimes devotees felt trapped. When I remember in Los Angeles, Prabhupada was there on the planet and some devotee was with closed doors was practicing. What are you doing? Oh, I was told I am a peacock, so I am practicing how to become a peacock. You don't have to practice. It will come when you are liberated. But Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says, our Siddha Pranali mantra is Trinadapi Sunichena. It is like the most important of all the teachings of all the Shastras. Because if you have this quality, you will come to Kirtaniya Sadhari. If you have Kirtaniya Sadhari, all dust, anger, everything will go away. Then you will attain love for Krishna. So this one Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur went to Bengal for preaching. And he was having very little time. He had to speak something. So he chose this verse. That's the most important verse for all Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Okay. Urdhva bahu karikah shuna sarva loka. Name sutra ganti para kante eish loka. Name in that room. Loudly, speak loud.
Raising my hands, I declare, everyone please hear me. Speak
on the thread of holy name and wear it on your neck for continuous remembrance.
I will read the purport. When chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra in the beginning, one may commit many offenses which are called Namabhas and Namaparad. In this stage, there is no possibility of achieving perfect love of Krishna by chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Therefore, one must chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra according to the principles of the above verse. Trinad api suni chena taror eva sahishnuna. Please listen very carefully. Next line. One should note in this connection that chanting involves the activities of the upper and lower lips as well as tongue. Upper lip, lower lip and tongue. All three must be engaged in chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. The words Hare Krishna should be very distinctly pronounced and heard. I repeat, the words Hare Krishna should be very distinctly pronounced and heard. Sometimes one mechanically produces a hissing sound instead of chanting with proper pronunciation with the help of the lips and tongue. Hissing sound means like that. Chanting is very simple, but one must practice it seriously. Again, chanting is very simple, but one must practice it seriously. Therefore, the author of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, advises everyone to keep this verse always strung about his neck. So this is, I have nothing more to say because the purport is so clear. Prabhupada said we should have the movement of the upper lip and lower lip. Actually, although I have been chanting for almost 3 decades, 35 years now, I had this problem also. And one devotee, because generally devotees out of respect, they don't correct it. One devotee very respectfully told me, Prabhuji, just check your chanting. And being proud as I am, I became so angry. He says, what is wrong? Why are you saying? So then he told me, record your chanting. So I recorded my chanting. And you'd be surprised, different mantras were coming. The first two malas was very smooth. Then it gradually slipped into missing of the words. Hare Krishna, Ram 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 Hare, like that. So here Prabhupada says very clearly, movement of upper lip, like, please try to say with me, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. There is movement of upper lip, lower lip and tongue. And generally, when you fall asleep, the first symptom of falling asleep is that your chanting volume and this lips movement goes down. So my suggestion is, if you want to chant nicely, as now we will be doing one practice round and then we will go for breakfast. And so when we chant, try to sit, Prabhupada would say, sit in a erect posture. You know, like, have you heard this cassette of Prabhupada? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, sit properly. Sitting properly, it helps. Although this is, if somebody has backache problem, then no problem. And then keep this left first two fingers like this, in this posture. It's called it's one of the posture which helps the concentration. And the hand can be on the knees, and in a very erect posture we chant the Maha Mantra. And Prabhupada writes that distinct pronunciation should be there. Let us chant one mala like this and then we will conclude. Everybody has their bead bags, or if you don't have bead bags, you can just chant on your fingers. We will chant together this one mala. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta. Of course, because we did together, it took almost 14 minutes. But on your own, if you do, you know, we have to chant together, doesn't mean synchronizingly, but once in a while this is helpful. Everybody could concentrate? Was it good? So we will just end with one last verse which is left. One of the Matajis can read the translation. It's the last verse. Prasadam is not ready as yet. How many of you like to come after Prasadam to chant more rounds? We can chant till 12:45 or till 1 o'clock, 2 hours. Now it is 10:15, so we will break till 10:45. 10:45 we can start again. Those of you who can adjust the other services, please repeat this verse behind me. Prabhu agya kara ei shloka acharana avashya paibe tabe shri krishna charana. One of the matajis can read. This is the conclusion of the seminar, so I wanted to end with this. He says, one who strictly follows the principles. What are the principles? What are the principles? Trinadapi sunichena tarorapi saishnana amanina manad. He You should follow in the footsteps of Lord Chaitanya Goswami. Goswami means Rupa Goswami, Haridas Thakur. What will he achieve? The ultimate goal of life, which is the lotus feet. Let us spend few, half a minute offering prayer to Lord Jagannath that we may follow this verse perfectly and achieve perfection of life, Krishna Prem, in this life. And we inspire others to do that also. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare.